Hey everyone, I'm Zoe Hewitt and welcome to our new series highlighting interesting nonprofits that need your help. Today we're starting out at the Ojai Raptor Center. They take in injured and orphaned raptors, rehabilitate them, and release them back into nature.
Raptors are birds of prey. They're ones that hunt with their talons.
This is one of the new cages that's just been built on the property. Let's go on in. This is Newton's home. He's going to come out and visit with us for a little bit.
He was imprinted on people. It's when people try and keep them as pets and they don't see another one of their kind. So it's a mental social disorder and they can't be released. They never mate. They never know how to hunt.
What does Newton do as an educational bird?
He goes out and educates about local environmental issues and about preserving habitat for all wildlife.
What should you do if you find an animal?
You have to observe first. Does that animal really need to be rescued? It is not true if you touch a baby bird that the mom won't take care of it. That's a myth.
Can you teach us how to hoot like Newton?
Sure. They either do a five note or hoo 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 hoo.
So how would I make the same?
You just have to practice.
Hoo-hoo, hoo-hoo, hoo-hoo.
It's a little high, so you want to go a little deeper.
Hoo-hoo, hoo.
Yeah. Birds of prey are very unique. They have a upper and lower eyelid like us, and they have a nictitating membrane that washes the eye and slides across. They can't move their eyes in their skull. So their eyes are fixed in the skull. So if he needs to see something behind him, he can turn his head all the way to the back. This is the top of the food chain. There's 750 pounds of pressure per square inch in these talons.
What about his beak?
That also is very strong. They use it for ripping and tearing and dispatching their prey, but I worry more about talons than I do about their bill.
You called it a bill. Is there a difference between a bill and a beak?
Just technical terminology, yes. Bill is correct, beak is not correct, but I say beak too.
So who has a beak then?
Nobody. They all have bills.
Oh, any bird.
In the ornithology word, yes.
Oh, I did not know that.
We've all been taught beak, but yeah. It actually truly is a bill.
Fascinating. And now we've learned a lot of things for today.
Once they leave the hospital unit, they go into an intermediate cage prior to coming into a large flight such as this one. This is the final stage for conditioning and release back to the wild. The large flight was 260 feet in an L shape, so the birds can bank and turn. And it's 16 feet high and 30 feet wide.
And you said that's the largest in the state.
The largest I know of. It's a very tough decision to put an animal into captivity the rest of its life. The reason we do have education animals in captivity is because of the education aspect of what we do. And they can't be released. All the birds that we have in our captivity in our education program cannot be released to the wild. They have an injury they've sustained.
You see a lot of shows like take the dollar bill out of my hand. What do you think of those?
As long as they're educating, I think that's great. If they're just doing it for fun and games, I don't know what kind of message that really sends to people.
And do you think the birds feel one way or another about learning these behaviors?
I think it really depends on the bird. When you have animals such as crows, ravens, magpies, parrots, their intelligence level is so much higher. They really enjoy working to perform, you know, like an Australian shepherd. They want to work. They want to please you. And so some of those animals, that behavior is just in their nature. Mm-hmm. Hawks, not so much. You can certainly train them to go from point A to point B, but you're not going to probably train him to take a dollar bill from anybody, and you wouldn't want to with those talons.
That'd be quite a show. Everything's donation. What do you need the most here?
Money is always the biggest need. You can help financially by sponsoring an animal, and then the person gets a certificate of appreciation and a photograph of the animal.
It's not often that people get to come here, so your open house is a really big deal. What will people get to see?
We will have all of our education birds out with handlers in kind of a festival situation. They'll be able to tour the facilities. We will also do little presentations on the stage.
And is there a fee to get in?
We have a $5 suggested donation.
I think Newton and I really got along in part because of my shirt. It's like I've got a family photo right here. Now there is a lot going on at the Ojai Raptor Center. They've got rehabilitation, they've got releasing, they've got education, you name it. They've also got volunteers and they need your help. So visit the Ojai Raptor Center online for more information, and I'll see you at the next nonprofit.